Howdy! It's time for the big daily. ICYFAR, what up? And what up, ladies and gentlemen? Animals and beasts, creatures of the dark. Today, we are going to be doing an episode with no secrets. It's a simple concept. Every single time you start an upgrade, every single time you put down a tech structure, not every single production structure, but every tech structure, every upgrade, you have to announce it to your opponent. Awesome. So before we dive into that, because we've got a bunch of replays and that's going to be awesome, let's announce next week's topic so you guys can start doing that already. It is going to be confusion. It's a pretty simple one, pretty easy to play, but just adds a little bit of fun. You must take your third base as your natural. So you would take your third base before you take your second base. Submit your replays, as always, through to Aeon Blue. Let me just post that info there in chat. And for you guys in YouTube, it's down below the stream and the information as well. So submit some replays for that. Have your chance to get your replay featured. As always, bronze, silver, gold, platinum, diamond, masters, GM. Doesn't matter your skill level, please do submit them. And you know, that's awesome because we've actually got a really good range of replays today. So I will be keeping an eye on my mic throughout today. My mic may cut out, but I thought I fixed it yesterday. I spent like 4 hours with it just working fine, and then it cut out right before I went to sleep. So I'm gonna keep an eye on that, see if it cuts out at all, and do some more troubleshooting today. But for now, let's dive on into game, and let's have some fun watching some games with no secrets. Ba-bom! Ooh, we got like epic music to start things off. Let me just... Yeah, everything's good. I'm always paranoid that I've messed up my settings, but we've actually done it well. Oh, right. Spawning up here in the top right-hand side of Frost, it is MGG Metastatic. Now we're starting here with a Silver League replay. And up against Metastatic, down here in the bottom right-hand side, our blue Terran, it is Wraith. Now, I think this might be Bloody Wraith, who's an admin actually for a bunch of our tournaments down here in Australia. And she actually does a lot to kind of, you know, help run all the tournaments and everything. So if it is, then that should be awesome. Of course, looks like she's just gonna scout out early and come over here. And what a challenge it is for this daily. I feel like it's psychological almost more than anything else, because so many players are so afraid of what they're doing being countered in game. I know I am. If my opponent knows exactly what's happening, it gets awkward really fast. And Wraith is going to have to announce every single thing that she does here. So this is going to get super, super weird really fast. Looks like Metastatic there. Locks her inside. Is going to pump out a Marine and trap this SCV as well. Goodbye, SCV. And looks like Metastatic's actually just going for a very fast expansion with no gas. So the old One Racks Expand, a classic build here. Some Wings of Liberty stuff. And it looks like Wraith going for her own expansion as well. She hasn't taken any tech yet. She's avoided so far going for any tech structure or any upgrades. But there we go. Factory. Is it going to get announced? This one might have been submitted by Metastatic. I'm not sure. MGG Metagame Gods, also an Australian-based clan, I believe. Definitely Southeast Asian. Oh, he's actually going to get in and get a nice scout out here. Sees the reactor finish, sees that factory down, and the second gas. Nice scout here from Metastatic. And going to see that command center at the natural as well. Run around in circles. So we haven't? I think it must be Metastatic, right? He's just avoiding going tech so that he doesn't have to announce it. Yeah, this is going to be Metastatic. So he's like, well, if I only build mineral units, then I never build an upgrade, I never build tech, then I never need to announce what I'm doing, right? So this is a clever way to work around the problem. Four Marines building at a time, four more barracks going down. Ah, Metastatic, you sly dog. Sly dog, completely working his way around the challenge. Meanwhile, Rafe going for some siege tanks, going for a starport. It looks like Rafe isn't the one playing the challenge here. Metastatic is a grim name, indeed. Oh, coffee is so good. So good in a cold morning. I stole some of my housemate's hazelnut coffee and it is damn beautiful. Oh. Naughty, naughty. There is some dirtiness that's coming across this map right now. Oh, what are these SCVs up to? I think we're definitely going to be seeing a bunker rush right now. Back at home, 8 barracks are up. There is massive marine production and Metastatic's about to put some hurt on, but Rafe, she's already got a tank up, or he's already got a tank up. And, nice blasts going down. Oh my god. Metastatic here, just losing almost all the units on the way through. Is he gonna get one SCV? Doesn't even get a single SCV. Massacred. Good hold there by Rafe. A tough start to things for Metastatic. Metastatic's definitely got a hell of a lot more marine production on the way. The question is, can you make it happen with only mineral units? That wasn't even the challenge, but that is a way to fight around the challenge, so fair enough. Third command center is going down. He is up a whole bunch of workers. The macro has been really good with nothing to focus on except minerals. The spending is getting, going really well here. These marines going to break down these rocks, going to work their way out. Meanwhile, over on the blue side, we've got 2 more barracks going down. Continued siege tank production. And looks like I think double. Yeah, we got Vikings on the way as well now. So tank, medevac, marine, Viking. And that looks like we might be gearing up for a pretty big push soon. Let's check out the scouting. No idea. Rafe has no idea. She's up against a mass of marines swelling out of this base right now. And funnily enough, even with 8 barracks, Metastatic can't keep up with production. So he's going to have to build even more barracks. And just keep on diving that out. So many marines are going to flood out onto this map. Tankivacs are going to be such a big problem. If they get microed around a lot, these marines without stim are going to struggle really hard to ever make contact. On the plus side, Metastatic doesn't have any upgrades either yet. And here comes that push. It's looking pretty scary. Nice spot of marines out for Metastatic. Metastatic doesn't have that many more units. It's going to be a tough fight no matter what. Looks like Rafe has scanned. Oh no. Oh, Metastatic's coming out! Mass Marine, he's gonna get on top of this before the tank's set up! Oh, great stutter step. One tank goes down before it can do anything. And it looks like Metastatic actually gets right on top of this push and shuts it down super hard. Damn, just surviving with a few red hit point Marines. And the hand has been shown. Rafe has got to know now. Whoa, this guy is just massing Marines. He's doing something utterly crazy at this point. And he's got 3 bases fully saturated on minerals. Only 48 SCVs, but when you don't have gas, you don't need that many SCVs. That's way up on the 28 of Rafe. And the Marines are continuing to produce here. 8 Marines at a time still flooding out across here. And Rafe trying to get out some Marauders, trying to get something beefier up in front. But without any siege tanks to add splash damage, this is going to be a tough fight. These Marines coming across this map right now, are they going to be able to overwhelm? I think with the medevacs, the blue Marines should stand strong. All the Metastatic's Marines fall down pretty quickly. But hey, when you've got 3 bases fully saturated and you're floating 1,000 minerals, time to go up to 14 barracks. You know, 8 barracks wasn't enough. Let's go to 14 barracks. Metastatic's just preparing for endless waves of Marines here. And I guess it does kind of fit the challenge. There's no secrets involved here right now. And oh man, those Marines just killing rocks while they get shot to pieces. They all, high on something, doing target practice out in the wilderness. Didn't even realize the tank, 2 Marauders and 10 Marines come up and blast them to pieces. Right now, we've got a huge push out here. A bunch of Marines, Marauders, a tank, and a couple of Marauders. There's not that many Marines here for Metastatic. Once again, though, no stim or combat shields here for Rafe. Rafe's pushing. Oh, Rafe's unit's getting a little bit spread apart. That tank needs to siege up really badly. And it looks like, oh, Metastatic sees the tank exposed. Rafe sends it too far forward. The tank's going to get focused down. Oh, Rafe taking huge damage here. Those Marauders tanking a lot, but they're not dishing out a lot of damage in return. The medevacs can't heal fast enough. And it looks like Metastatic Mass Marines, one of the most straightforward and yet powerful strategies out there, is just going to be overwhelming. Oh, even dropping a mana mule. Oh my god, the BM. The BM. Don't get ahead of yourself, mate. Oh, another wave of Marines comes down. Wraith needs to stop attacking. Wraith needs to get out of here. That's just so many Marines right now. What's Wraith got left back at home? Wraith's down at 33 SCVs. A couple Marines, a couple Marauders in production. One more siege tank. But Wraith really needs to turtle up against the numbers of Metastatic. Metastatic is up to 14 barracks. And there's a few more command centers that are now down. The income here is insane. More than double the mineral income from Metastatic. And Metastatic's just going to completely avoid taking gas the entire game. I love it when someone does something a little bit sly to just completely bypass the challenge. It's so beautiful. Roddy was talking about eating pizza last night. Hey, Castaway. Sounds exciting, man. Oh, is she here? Rafe. Oh, if only the tanks could move up and set up there and just blast these Marines down again. I'm not sure if Rafe realizes. Oh, but Rafe's got plenty of Marauders in front. Marauders, they're not amazing versus Marines, but they absorb so much damage with the tanks behind them, they'll actually do a pretty good job. Do we see more barracks coming down behind this? Yeah, just another 9 barracks, just going up to another 10 barracks, going up to a casual 24 barracks, taking a fifth base. Even more command centers as well. Oh my god. This is beautiful. This makes me so happy right now. Metastatic is going to show us the power of mineral-only macro. And it looks like Wraith going to split off some units, a tank and a full medevac to go to a drop. Meanwhile, Metastatic trying to deny that third and bringing across... Oh my god! Oh, so many Marines. Oh, so many Marines. Wraith, with this tiny elite army, is going to have to face off against a force much, much larger. But, I mean, Metastatic here can just reproduce so damn easily. So many units on the way. These Marines are just chilling down here. Here comes the drop! Here comes the drop! Tank, a bunch of Marauders and Marines going to drop into this base. And, uh-oh! Going to actually just wipe out this entire mineral line really quickly. Nice drop here from Wraith, doing a small dent in the huge economy of Metastatic. Metastatic's coming back with some Marines, but that tank is going to start shelling down on those really well. And Wraith actually going to pick up and get out of there! Go! Go! Run! Oh, actually going to boost deeper into the main base. Ballsy maneuver from Wraith there. Meanwhile, Metastatic, he's had enough. He's going to dive across the map and try to get inside. The tank, Marines, Marauders are doing well there. Here we go. These Marines trying to walk in, but oh my god, there's just too much blue here. There's that tank doing massive damage. It is set up beautifully. And Wraith there with a great hold. The tank and the Marauders in the main as well also hanging on. Looks like Wraith finally grabbing some ground in this game. However, will it matter? Metastatic right now has so many bases, can just reproduce, is building 23 Marines at a time. The rally point has changed directions, and almost instantaneously an army just magically appears out of nowhere. Can these Marines finally get rid of these Marauders in this siege tank from inside this base? Great focus fire from Metastatic. Takes down the siege tank, takes down the Marauders, and goodbye medevacs. Nice play there from Metastatic to get rid of that. Meanwhile, scouting orbital command center starts to maraud around Wraith's base. Wraith finds this very ballsy command center outside her base as well, and she's gonna be freaking out right now. This is getting really strange right now. As Wraith, you're like, oh wow, this guy's expanding pretty fast, building a lot of Marines. Little does she know, there are bases there, and there. The first planetary, no, that's an orbital as well. That's an orbital that's going to start up over there. And now Wraith is wanting to counterattack, leaving one siege tank at home. Those siege tanks are so important against these masses of Marines. How many Marines are there actually out right now, though? There are 23 Marines still building at a time. More and more Marines flooding. I think it's time for that F2 button to be used. Here comes the Stim. Wraith with the Stim and the combat shields, as well as the +1 attack. The bio with the medevacs here is so much stronger for Wraith. SCVs being pulled in, Marines being pulled in. But Metastatic, oh, I don't know if this is enough Marines. He's taking down the right flank pretty well. These Marauders are starting to fall, but losing an orbital command center. The Marines starting to be routed a little bit. Metastatic needs to regroup and engage this all at once. I think he's going to go for it. He's going for it! And there he goes, dives on in, tries to focus fire these units. Goodbye, medevacs. Actually focusing on the medevacs first of all, trying to get rid of the staying power of Wraith's force. Does work decently, gets two of them, but he's going to need a lot more Marines than that. Meanwhile, some Marines setting up for a big counterattack here. They might be able to go in and engage that siege tank and dive in on top. Remember, Wraith cannot produce this army easily, whereas Metastatic can just replace these marines endlessly, but there's just the combat shield is a plus one, the stim is just so damn powerful. Needs another wave of marines here. Metastatic starting to queue up a few more marines. Is going to be diving in on top, and oh man, they will just get minced to pieces. The stim is too powerful. The marine counterattack still chilling down there. And despite the 24 barracks, 6 base production, I think Metastatic might just get overwhelmed here by the superior upgrades in tech. Oh man. All these marines just popping out into their death. And it looks like Metastatic's having a really tough time. Let's swap to Metastatic's cam. Let's get inside the head of our mass marine player. Gonna be moving down with these marines. One last big army here. Gonna try and overwhelm this. Or one of the last armies, I should say. Gonna try and get on top of that tank before it can fire. The tank doesn't get a shot off. The marines are getting on top. And now, finally, the numbers are here. Metastatic overwhelms. Metastatic is gonna hold. Metastatic does it. Mass marine only. And manages to hold on to the majority of the production. Lost a few bases in the process, however, there are still orbital commands on all of these expansions over here. Plenty of mules to be dropped, and 22 marines at a time still producing. Command center starting to rebuild, but Wraith still pushing across this map. Wraith's main base is now out. Wraith's natural getting low as well. Wraith really needs to go take a third or fourth base. Metastatic still chilling over here with these marines, trying to stop that third from being taken. And Wraith here, pushing across this map, even bringing some SCVs maybe to build some bunkers, and Wraith is going to try and thrust into that production one more time, but so many marines are coming out. Metastatic here is still refusing to take gas, refusing to actually go for any sort of tech or upgrade, which you have to now. And sorry for the mic there, guys. As I mentioned earlier on, I thought I fixed my mic yesterday. Turns out I didn't quite manage to do it. And after I got it working for about 4 or 5 hours straight without a disconnect, and then it disconnected right before I went to sleep. So I was like, oh, why would you lie to me, microphone? Why wouldn't you just disconnect straight away? So we're just gonna keep a close eye on that. Do apologize for that minute or so of it being muted. And we are gonna jump on through. Looks like Rayfair grappling with the loss to the just unlimited marines that seem to flood out endlessly here. He's gonna type out GG, and Metastatic has taken the game. Thanks for the tips there, guys, in chat. I think that was about 1 minute of Mike. I didn't turn the mic off myself, guys. It just turns itself off, unfortunately. I tried a few things yesterday. I'm gonna try a few things today as well, and we'll get it sorted out. We'll fix it up. All right, guys. So we're gonna dive into the next game. This one, I believe, is diamond. So I think that was silver. I think we got two diamonds, and then we have a GM replay, which I believe is meant to be quite fail. So it says fail in the title for it. So I have no idea actually what happens in these replays until I watch them. But that should be fun. Hey guys, just playing with the overlay there. As I realized that I got adjusted. For pigsty. For the different overlay which Insano prefers to use. But anyway guys, let's dive on into game here. And it is gonna be a TVP this time around. And spawning up here in the top left hand side, our red Terran player. It is Silva. Oh, so this is an old replay. So my hotkeys have gone and reset because I had to exit out of game to do it. So we're just gonna very quickly open up some new hotkeys, make sure and turn some settings on the way they should be, because slightly older replays unfortunately screw that. All right guys, so sporting up here in the top left-hand side, it is Silva. I love and spawning down here in the bottom right hand side, our blue Protoss player, it is Flying Turtle, who said, good luck and have fun my friend, I love you so much, so I will tell you what I build. And it looks like Flying Turtle here is our submitter. He's the guy playing No Secrets. He's going to announce absolutely everything that he does. Technically, I would say you don't need to announce like every gate. But that's nice to announce the first gate. And it looks like Flying Turtle actually going to be going gate Nexus here. Just quite a typical opening. Yep. Meanwhile, has scouted over there. And Silva. I have no idea what that says. Non Seriex Teul. You guys can let me know if that's a language. Is that like some bizarre French? Cybernetic score goes down. All right, we finally get to see No Secrets in action. And I'm so curious to see how this goes. Of course, with this, one of the big things I've anticipated and kind of hoped for is people assuming their opponent is lying, because I think that's just the funniest thing ever. If you tell someone you're going DTs, they don't believe it, don't get defense, and then you just kill them with DTs. But we're going to have to wait and see if that actually happens. Flying Turtle here, getting the core, getting the second gas, second pylon. Very standard build up here from Flying Turtle so far. An Adept and a Mothership Core up against the Reaper from Captain Silver over here. He didn't tell him about the Nexus. What a cheater. It is actually only upgrades and tech structures. And Wolfgate Research. There we go. That's an upgrade. So that one he had to call, as well as the Cyber Core. So Flying Turtle does announce that. And the Reaper's going to come on in here, see the Mothership Core, and does get deflected. Silver sees it as a regular opening so far. Second Barracks is down, and then a Factory. Looks like a 2-1-1 opening for Silver. So going to be going for a very fast Stim, Marines, and a drop-in. Oh! Hey, buddy, do you want to be friends? Here's a Frisbee with spikes on it. Don't you love the Adept's attack? Like, it's basically a Huntress attack from Warcraft 3. It is just a Frisbee with spikes on it. So you just like throw it at like a Zergling and it just leaps into the air and catches it in its mouth and just rips the cutling's face open. And that's why everyone hates Adepts. They're douchebags, man. Robo and Twilight going down. Turtle just gonna try and play this super solid macro, but announcing everything that he's doing. Silver here, probably freaking out a little bit, wondering what the hell is going on right now. Even announcing the gateways, of Flight Turtle is going to announce literally everything this entire game, which is beautiful. That is beautiful. Starport going down here, along with that reactor to get those medevacs on out. It looks like, I think Silver's going to commit really hard just to the Marine drop, like kind of TVZ style. Yeah, Stim starting up now as well. Lots of Marines in production. Flying Turtle. He can commentate the game for me, man. He's just gonna go blink. Looks like he's gonna take the macro approach and say, you know what, you can't just hard counter? You can't just hard counter macro. So I'm just gonna macro really hard. It's pretty standard. And I'm just gonna play it so well that I have a good chance of winning. Gonna be going up for the third and fourth gas quite early as Flying Turtle. I'm not gonna be opting for like a really fast 4-minute Nexus, but still the option to go for that in the near future. Looks like an engineering bay here. Yep, Silver doesn't trust that there's no DTs. Is still gonna be getting up an eBay. Can obviously get the upgrade out of that as well. Actually, it needs a third gas. Gonna start up Medivac production, Marauders, and so on. Stork is starting to warp in here for Turtle. What can Turtle see? I think Turtle's coming across with that first Observer now, so that's gonna get some fantastic vision. And a Warp Prism is coming out here as well. Four more gateways! Oh, where? Oh, he's announced it. He's gotta go for all four. You gotta go for all four gateways. Yep. So it looks like we're gonna see 7-gate Blink Prism, maybe Adepts as well afterwards. So Flying Turtle committing a lot to this, and potentially wanting to go very aggressive. Silver here, with the two Medivacs, has to not overextend into this. This Observer sees everything for the moment. Marines, Marauders, and it will see those two Medivacs soon, I think. But oh, it's actually going to pull back just as these Medivacs are popping out. So it might be a little bit slow. It might not see the pickup. And it looks like it's time. Flying Turtle pushing out across this map. 7 gateways and a Warp Prism and an Adept going to just shove across this map right now and start looking to put the hurt on. Interestingly, elevatoring to here rather than over there. Did that Reaper see this? I don't think it did. This Reaper's going across the map right now. And Flying Turtle trying to get this super sneaky assault on over here. The gateways are all finishing up. Meanwhile, Silver back at home is actually just camping, just kind of chilling at home for the moment. And Turtle wants to put on the aggression. We've got Stalkers, we've got a Warp Prism and Adept going to be coming in. This Observer does provide some nice high ground vision. The Reaper's going to be a pain in the ass. It does see a lot of gateways, it confirms that, and it's got to freak out right now. Silver has got to be worried about what he's seen. These Stalkers are getting ready. They want to dive on into this main base, and I don't think Silver's ready for it. Stim is finished, but there isn't much else done. Goodbye, combat shields. The Stalkers snipe that down almost instantly. One Stalker gets focused down very early on. Good micro here from Silver. Gets two Stalkers. Does lose two add-ons, though. And Silver! Whoa, super ballsy. I thought he was going to go for a drop right then. The Observer sees everything, though, and this is a crazy Stalker count right now. We've got 18 Stalkers here. They're going to assault the front, and great Blink micro so far. These damaged Stalkers being pulled to the back. The Bunker goes down very quickly. The Warp Prism is set up, but there's no high ground vision right there. Flying Turtle can only see to the ramp, but the Widow Mine's only now getting set up, and it looks like Flying Turtle's done a fantastic job. Oh, fantastic Blink Micro to pull away from that. Silver had everything announced to him, but still was not able to stop this relentless onslaught. Flying Turtle here, just playing a very solid macro opening into a huge Blink timing, announces everything. And who would have known? No GG. Ouch. Ouch. Of course, that's just got to screw with your head. Silver was floating 1,600 minerals at the end there. I feel like if anything brought the tilt, it was just your opponent, kind of telling you absolutely everything that's going on the entire time, because you start second-guessing yourself and overthinking things. So it seems like if we see any more games like that, then I think we're going to be pretty sure that what this is really doing, this challenge, is it's simulating shit talk and it's just throwing people off. And apparently, it decided to log out, so I need my authenticator to log back in because that was a slightly old replay. One second, guys. Authenticator. Sorry guys, it battlenet security. Can't have people stealing me account, eh? Alright, alright, alright. Subspace says, Pig, I swear the text gave way more info than the scans. I dare say so. I dare say so. All right. The next one's a diamond as well, but it is a ZVT. And I'm pretty sure this one's submitted by the Zerg because it is a regular viewer and baller of the channel, B Muffin or BM Muffin. Probes here as well, bringing out some Swift Rage in chat. Probe, your replay is up last. So Probe actually submitted a GM replay, a PvP, which is going to be the game after this one. That one we just did was the shortest game of the lot, I believe. So we're going to dive into the next one. It's going to be an Apotheosis ZVT. And it should be some good fun. And apparently it's just changed the overlay on us, I guess because it's an old replay, but it's Apotheosis. This should be the most recent patch. I don't know. Sometimes Battle.net is like this enigma to me. It's really bizarre. So I just want to see, because it should just load up the same version of StarCraft, but for some reason the settings have changed. No? Apparently, was there a patch after they brought out the new maps? I guess there was the Nova patch, and that was slightly different to the maps patch, right? Okay, so we're just going to have to watch this one in old mode, unfortunately, because it is an old replay. That's a shame. The overlay is not as pretty, not as nice, but that's all right. We can do it anyway, and it should be just fine. Should be just fine, guys. All right. So this next map, it is going to be Apotheosis. It is going to be a ZVT submitted by our Zerg player, who's going to announce absolutely everything that he does in this game. Spawning up here in the top left-hand side of our map. Let's get our settings going. Unfortunately, I can't do this before the game starts because it resets them. Because it exits StarCraft whenever it loads up an old replay. All right, and hotkeys as well. And spawning up here in the top left-hand side is our Zerg player. It is Bee Muffin, harvesting some cake. Those cakes actually look pretty tasty. And his opponent spawning down here in the bottom right-hand side of Apotheosis, it is Sparkster. Shut up, please. Oh, this one's going to be great. So Bee Muffin just says, good luck, have fun. Sparkster already says, shut up, please. Little does he know that our Zerg player is going to spend the entire game regaling him with what tech and upgrades he's going for. And I feel like if someone gets mad when someone says, good luck, have fun, then they're basically going to be tearing their hair out and just shitting on the floor in rage by the end of a match where the opponent won't shut up. So this is going to be amazing. And that's actually a barracks and an insanely fast second gas. Sparkster, are you doing a one base all in? What is this? Like, there is fun playing Stark. I love people like this. And B Muffin starts announcing, says pool. There's always these people who are like, it's not even fun. I just play this game because I hate having fun, and this is not fun, so that's why I keep doing it. And you're like, what? I don't understand what the hell you're talking about. These people are the best. I love it. I'm not going for an orbital just yet. Sparkster, a little bit confused by the announcement of the spawning pool there. So let's see how long it takes Sparkster to piece together what's going on. It's probably going to take a few more tech structures and upgrades before he kind of realizes, wait, what the hell? You're telling me what you're doing? And then we're going to have to see how he reacts, because that's going to be... I just want to see the rage. I want to see some salt flow out. We're going to enter like the Dead Sea of Terran tears. It's going to fill up all these little channels across Apotheosis with just fucking salty, salty Terran tears. It's going to be great. Bee Muffin. It's just droning on up.
Oh, yeah.
Thank you so much, Secretly Psycho, for sending that one viewer over. I appreciate the host, mate. And Bee Muffin's going to be going, hiding that drone of that third to take that in the near future. But really, it's all about what Sparkster wants to do here. Already a tech lab on that factory and a starport, either going for very fast Cyclones or very fast Banshees, or maybe even both. And that's going to be really interesting to see what he does with it. Sparkster still has not got that orbital command center, still not dropping mules here, actually leaving him very mineral starved. Interesting build order. And Bee Muffin only now is going to start to get his first glimpse of the Terran units, and he's just going to see Marines on the edge of the base and nothing else. So it's gonna be tough for Bee Muffin to defend this. And it's actually a medevac and a tank, so one base Marine tank all in. Yeah, extra barracks going down as well. I think it's just going to be unupgraded Marines and lots of tanks and medevacs, and that can be pretty tough to deal with. I mean, if we think about this map, I guess you could drop Yeah, you could kind of take the rocks down and drop tanks there. You could drop tanks like here as well. So here's kind of a triangle. The scariest points against tank drops are always triangles of death. It's where you can drop one corner, and then, one corner. So you can kind of rotate around, and it's really hard for ground units to get to you, whilst you can easily pick up and drop on any of the sides. Zergling starting to harass the front here, actually doing a good bit of damage to these depots. That's always a nice little bit of harassment there from Beamhoffen. Announces the Roachmoran as well going down at home. So far, just pretty much a macro build here out of Beamhoffen, just droning on up pretty hard, taking that third base. It's getting secured, but still, I mean, at this point, he's got to realize he's up against one base. What did he see there? He saw an extra barracks going down. Oh, siege tanks up! Ah, run, Zerglings! Run! Oh, they just barely got out of range. Of course, there's a delay on that tank shooting after it drops down. Overlord's going to go through the main. He's seen a tank evac. He sees multiple barracks, a factory with a tech lab, and a starport. Beamuffin has a lot of scouting. And we see in the production tab, queens, lots of queens, roaches, and zerglings all starting up. Beamuffin not taking any chances against this, wants to be really safe. And this first medevac, it's going to work its way across the map, but I don't know how much it's going to be able to get done. Looks like Beamuffin is very well prepared. He's up about 5 workers, but in the income, way ahead. Of course, mining off 2 bases of mineral patches, and he's looking really healthy. Actually built a Widow Mine here. Interesting. Maybe follow up with this Marine Widow Mine drop as well. Tank does drop down here, but Roaches and Lings are already on top of it. Medivac takes a bit of damage. Tank only tickles a queen. And Sparks is going to be as annoying as possible. He doesn't really have much macro to focus on. Oh, he's actually got double tank evac over here. Ooh, very cute. Starting to take some damage on these tanks and medevacs though, so I think Beamuffin is okay with these trades so far. Beamuffin has that superior income we were talking about, can afford to take some slightly awkward trades. And these queens going way off creep though, and that's making it a little bit awkward, but at the same time Sparkster has to micro in two very opposite positions, which makes it very difficult. So, looks like Sparks is just going to continue to be as annoying as possible, but these queens... Oh my god! Oh, that medevac is one shot from death, and this queen's gonna make sure it does not pick up. These queens coming in here relentlessly, are they gonna get it? The other tank comes in, but it's very weak as well. That tank gets shot down. Very nice defense from Beamuffin. And it looks like here comes the push, though. Sparks to massing up Marines, tanks, and the Widow Mine there. More drones coming out for Beamuffin. Ooh, he needs to not drone too hard. This is still a very scary push. That Overlord spotted it, though. That Overlord definitely saw this moving out. He's going, oh no, I don't think he's watching his minimap. Double Overlord, double Evo Chambers on the way. Lots of drones, building some spines at the front. So spines will buy time, but creep spread is really what he needs. Without creep, it's really hard to deal with Marines and tanks. But more Roaches are in production now. More Queens as well. Beamuffin just being inspired by the Mass Queen Blade. Great cancel on the double Evo Chamber. Realizes there's a big stream of units coming out. He's going to try and spread some creep out here. Get some more Roaches, some more Zerglings. Beamuffin wants to hang on here. Wants to get up some more tech. Actually, he built a lair. Did he announce the lair? He didn't announce the lair. Naughty, naughty. That's all right. Whenever 100% strict on the challenges, as I understand that when you're dealing with two tank evacs harassing you, you're going to forget about something. The queen's actually coming out all the way off creep. Oh, this is a really ballsy defense from Beamuffin. I think this might be coming out way too far as Roaches all just walking into the meat grinder. These queens, oh, getting super ambitious out here. They've got to focus down these medevacs. The queen's taking so much damage. The transfuse is sick. More Roaches and Lings joining the fray. The Marines are starting to fall a little bit, but too many Marines and Roaches and Zerglings are falling down at the same time. There we go. The Zerglings, they flood between those queens, take out most of the Marines. And there we go. Great focus fire from the queens. The medevacs are down. There goes your staying power. These tanks can't maneuver anymore. Beamuffin just going to continue to rally into this for the moment. Probably needs to pull back and rally for the moment. Needs to regroup. Still up massively in the income. Able to take appalling trades and still be way ahead, as is the case here. Terran's invested everything in these higher tech units that are way more efficient, but just doesn't have as much stuff. These spine crawlers edging their way back. They're buying time for now. There's only one medevac here to help edge forward. 6 ravages on the way. That gas from Beamuffin being put to good work. And there's no way one medevac can dodge from all the corrosive vials at once. Sparks are only really able to dodge one. Here we go, the Roach Ravager pushes on in. One tank goes down, a second tank goes down. And it looks like those Roaches and Ravagers going to pull back for the moment. Some nice corrosive vials. Oh, goodbye Marines. And Beamuffin putting on a clinic on how to defend this sort of crazy aggression here. Holding on very well for the moment. Still Marines stand though. Still there's 2 siege tanks in the back. One more medevac. Is it going to go down? It does go down. Nice focus fire there from B Muffin. This Ravager, unfortunately, a little bit excited. Gets blown to pieces very quickly. Oh, this is actually still going on, and B Muffin needs to regroup and engage all at once, but he keeps going in just a little bit too early. Oh my god, the units lost tab. More than double the resources lost here for B Muffin. Oh, Roach Speed is on the way. More queens, more roaches. This feels like how Zerg vs. Terran should be, right? Just these endless waves of Zerg just getting pummeled into the ground. But there's always more where that came from. These Marines chilling in front. The great thing for Sparkster here is you can always pull back the Marines, knock the rocks down, and the roaches won't be able to close. Those Marines trying to edge their way forward there, but the roaches, oh, they take a big bunch of tank shots, and Sparkster starting to maneuver these tanks forward as well, sieging up against this really well. Losing those Ravagers and Queens before was a big hit to B Muffin. Doesn't have as much mobility or range or anti-air on the army anymore. And now this attack's getting out of hand. B Muffin needs to break it. He needs to kill some of these siege tanks. One siege tank lifts up at the front. A nice corrosive bile or two goes down on the Marines. The medevacs start to fall, but a lot of the Roach Ravager goes down, and all of the siege tanks are still alive. A whole four siege tanks. That being said, Roach Speed is almost finished. B Muffin is hanging on for dear life, and he really needs to shove this attack back. But he's struggling for the moment. Sparkster, with the dedicated one base all in, is doing so much. And oh, these Ravagers and Lings, they're going to try and come in. They're going to try and take this engage. Nice corrosive biles. Two siege tanks go down before Sparkster can react. Great pickup there by B Muffin. Resets the tank count to three for now. Ooh, if you take those rocks down, that'll crush that siege tank. B Muffin's going to come in here. Roaches, Zerglings, and Ravagers. Oh, going to overwhelm those Marines. There we go. Nice corrosive biles starting to land on that siege tank in the back. The tank in the front lifts, but the tank in the back goes down. Very nice micro there on this tank on the right hand side, though, to keep that alive for a little bit longer. Once again saves it just before it goes down, but B Muffin's on top of it. He's going to be chasing that tank relentlessly. It does drop one more time, but corrosive biles on the left are almost going to kill that tank, and it looks like Sparks's attack has finally been held. These tanks, there's just too much Zerg on top of all of them. Tanks are finally going to be going down. All the tanks going down. That last medevac standing here being as annoying as possible, but I think B Muffin has held it. I don't think there's much that Sparkster can do from here. He's floating his main command center down. It's just five barracks, unupgraded marine production, still building those medevacs and tanks one at a time each. But what have we got? One siege tank, two medevacs, 10 marines, and a whole lot of cake. Up against a three base Zerg with a massive income lead, 1700 to zero. Literally infinite income compared to the Terran. This tank's going to try and go around and harass that, be as annoying as possible, but Sparks is in massive trouble right now. All these SCVs going to be mining from here, 26 SCVs on one base, going to try and drop some mules as well. This siege tank in the top right starts to blast down some drones. Nice harassment here from Sparkster. Ooh, going to take out actually a lot of drones. Gets up to two there. Damages a lot more of them though. And here comes the counterattack. B Muffin not going to give him the time that he needs to rebuild that tank count. Just going to engage now. The Roach Speed is good. The Ravagers are good. And B Muffin here not holding anything back, not telling any secrets. And Sparkster says, good effing game, man. GG's. All right. That was a decent game. I really wanted to see some more salt from that Terran, but unfortunately he went for the one base all in, obviously because he was pretty angry from the start of that game, so he was freaking out just a little bit. Sorry guys, thank you very much. And we got that one quickly. We got that one almost instantly. I was just saying that I feel like one of the best things about online competition is people are gonna cry their eyes out a lot more. So I really wish that game went just a little bit longer. And the Terran actually took two bases so we could hear more announcements of what the tech was and cry his eyes out little by little. But we got a little bit of salt. We got a GFG. We got a one base tank tank all in, and now we're gonna be going to a Korean GM PvP sent in by Probe, and this was labeled fail. And Probe's in chat as well, and he said, "Oh God, not that replay. It's so bad." So I'm looking forward to whatever we're gonna see here. I think it's gonna be pretty hard to make no secrets work in PvP at Korean GM level, but. Let's take a look at how this goes. All right, guys, pointing down here in the bottom right-hand side, our red Protoss. It is LLLLLII111. And his opponent spawning up here in the top left-hand side, it is LLLLLII111LLLLLLI. Exciting IDs for these players. I have no idea who's who. Obviously, we're going to find out when one guy starts announcing to the other guy what he's going for. Interestingly, will the Korean player even recognize what the hell the English words mean? Maybe not. Maybe not. I have absolutely no clue. Looks like Blue's gonna go out for a scout right now. Always good to see some high-level execution of our challenges. There was actually a really good one from Probe in the Proc City one, where he proxied like double Stargate, I think it was, and then, I can't remember if it was like Oracles, I think it was Phoenix. And then like took like a proxied base behind the gold, the rocks, the gold base on Dust Towers by like dropping there with a warp prism. It was pretty sick. And it looks like red is our probe. Two gates into a core as he announces. And he's gonna be going for that second pylon as well. Super standard stuff, pretty mirrored for both players. And here we go, the confusion begins. Is Probe going to clarify or is he just going to stay silent? I think he's just going to stay silent for now. Probe's like, indeed, that is a cybernetics core. Indeed. Double Stalker's going to start up here for Probe. Two Stalkers on the other side of the map as well. Neither player but going to be going for those Adepts. And Warpgate Research! And Blue's going to be getting a little bit confused here about what's going on. Of course, both players' probes have to leave each other's bases. Probe left much earlier and was already searching for pylons. Searching for proxies all over the place. And this is when we see the tech go down. Stargate for Blue up here. Meanwhile, Probe on the other side of things looks like he's just going to expand into Robo, I think. Yep, it's going to be expansion into Robo. This is a pretty safe expand build, getting the two Stalkers out nice and early first of all, and they're going to be going for that. Of course, we'll have to announce the Robo though, and that timing will tell Blue exactly what's going on. Blue's going to expand as well, but it's after four Stalkers and a Stargate, so it's going to be a much later expansion. Oh, Stalker engage in the middle of the map! Who gets the first shot off? That was about even, but Probe's shots spread out, whereas Blue's shots were focused on one Stalker. So, slight advantage to Blue, and there we have it, Robo! Announces his Robo tech as well. The question is, who's gonna panic and freak out in the face of this information? Is Blue like, am I getting mind gamed? Am I getting mind gamed? What the hell is going on? He's going Phoenix, and it's actually quite, not the slowest Phoenix, but it's slowish Phoenix. I guess if you want to expand and whatnot, you know, this is an okay time to go Phoenix. But just interesting, because I usually see that Stargate go down and go into the Phoenix production a little bit sooner if they are going to go for that. It looks like the Robo here is going to be finishing up. Probe's up about five workers right now, just being a lot more consistent in his probe production. And plus one air attack, the mind games begin. Ah, the old two-gate Robo into plus one flyer attack, of course. This is so great because He's doing the mind game, but what? Is he actually going to go into Phoenix himself?